नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, इन प्रेजेंट लेक्चर आई वुड बी टॉकिंग टू यू अबाउट कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ टायर। वी ऑल आर फैमिलियर विद टायर। दिस फैमिलियरिटी बिगैन इन आवर चाइल्डहुड व्हेन वी स्टार्टेड यूजिंग बाइसिकल। ऑफन वी गॉट पंक्चर्ड व्हील रिपेयर्ड। दैट प्रोवाइडेड अस एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू नो अबाउट टायर एंड ट्यूब। टायर्स यूज्ड इन व्हीकल्स आर क्वाइट सिमिलर टू दैट यूज्ड इन बाइसिकल्स और इवन इन मोटरसाइकिल्स। डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ टायर आर बीड, बीड फिलर, लाइनर, प्लाइज शोन एज प्लाई वन एंड टू, बेल्ट्स शोन एज बेल्ट वन एंड टू, ट्रेड्स, साइड वॉल and foam layer. To learn about details of construction, let us refer to diagram that gives cut section. Bead. This is a strand of wires that are twisted together to form bead. It gives circular shape to tire. It also secures tire to wheel. It can be seen in lowermost portion of tire. To keep tire in position when inflation pressure is low, bead locks are provided in wheel. Bead locks are not very popular as these make removal and mounting of tire difficult. Bead filler. It is made of rubber compound, wraps around bead and is shown in grey color. It provides strong support to tire. It may be noticed on upper side of bead. Liner. It forms a layer in tire structure and can be noticed as innermost layer shown in orange color. It is made of rubber compound. It contributes in retaining inflation pressure. Ply. Ply comprises of polyester, rayon or nylon cord with rubber impregnated. It is part of tire structure. It provides strength to tire and makes it capable of withstanding inflation pressure. Number of plies in a tire depend upon load it is required to take up. There are two plies shown in diagram, ply 1 in blue color and ply 2 in green color. Both plies may be seen next to liner in diagram. Belt. This is made of steel cords with rubber impregnated. It forms a layer in tire structure and provides stability to tread area. It is located above ply. As can be seen in diagram, there are two belts. Belt 1 is in cyan color and belt 2 is shown in magenta color. Tread. It forms outermost layer of tire as may be seen. As we know, it provides stability to vehicle as it moves. Side wall. It forms a wall on both sides of tire. It provides cover to plies and liner. It also provides strength to tire. Foam layer. This layer reduces tire noise as already explained in previous lecture. It is pasted on inner surface of tire and is shown in dull red color. To distinguish in a better manner belts, plies, liner and foam layer has been shown on bottom right side with same colors. Tires have classification based on their construction. On this basis there are bias ply tire, belted bias ply tire and radial ply tire. Belted bias ply tire is a variant of bias ply tire. Bias ply tire. This is the oldest tire design. Cotton thread was used in earlier days, but now it has been replaced by nylon cord. When vehicle is stationary or remains parked, surface of the tire in contact with floor becomes flat. This is due to load. If it remains parked for a long time, nylon cord has a tendency to adopt flat shape. It causes a flat spot in tire. It is known as square tire syndrome. It happens particularly in cold climatic conditions. It is nothing very serious. As vehicle moves and tire is heated up, flat spot vanishes. Nylon cords are impregnated with rubber. Layer thus formed is termed as ply. Referring to diagram that presents view with cut section to show details. Diagram shows tire with two plies mentioned as ply 1 and ply 2. Plies are in even number. Using odd number of plies causes pull in tire that is undesirable. Number of plies varies and depend upon load carried by tire. Ply runs in this type of tire from bead to bead. Heating of tire is reduced as there is no flexing of rubber. Plies have nylon cords, as already mentioned, arranged in a particular fashion. With center line, it makes an angle of 35 degree as shown. This inclination may vary. Lower angle provides stability at high speed, but ride becomes rough. It may be noticed that cords are in opposite direction in two plies that are shown. Side walls of these tires do not bulge even at low inflation pressure. Belted bias ply tire. This is variant of bias ply tire as already mentioned. It has belts located between plies and treads. Referring to diagram, again showing cut section of tire. It should not be difficult to visualize that treads form top layer. Next, there is belt 1 shown in red color. Below it, there is belt 2 shown in blue color. Belts are followed by ply 1 and ply 2. Belts are continuous. These wrap around plies. Belts 2 are rubber impregnated on cords. These provide strength to tire. In place of cotton, synthetic material, nylon is now commonly used to make cords. It provides better strength. Kevlar, commercial name, is also used. It provides very good strength but is costly. Cords are replaced by steel wire or aramid fibers. Aramid fibers are a class of heat resistant and strong synthetic fibers. These enhance tire strength and its life. Cords are placed diagonally opposite to each other. It is in similar manner to what we have seen in plies. Radial ply tire. These are also belted tires. Difference lies in manner in which cords are placed in plies. Referring to diagram, ply 1 and 2 lie one above another. Cords shown are horizontal. These run from bead to bead and are parallel to each other. Because cords are radial, therefore the name radial ply tire. To distinguish between two plies, these have been shown in two colors, that is cyan and green. Nowadays, it is quite common to use nylon, polyester, fiberglass or Kevlar to make cords used in plies. Belts 1 and 2 are shown in red and blue colors. Tires described are two-ply double belted tires. As already mentioned, number of plies goes on increasing as per load requirement. Tire material. Tires have treads, belts, reinforced plies and liner that is known to us. These have air inside at high pressure. Therefore, these are also termed as pneumatic tires. Materials used to make tire are natural rubber, synthetic polymers, steel, textile, carbon black, and amorphous precipitated silica, antioxidants, antiozonants, and sulfur and zinc oxide. Natural rubber. It provides tear and fatigue crack resistance to tire. This improves the performance of tire. Natural rubber comes from white sap of Hevea brasiliensis tree, commonly known as rubber plant. It grows to a height of about 100 to 130 feet. Its life is about 100 years. When bark, the outermost layer of stem is removed, white milky sap flows freely from tree. It is a native to rainforests in Amazon region of South America. Though hundreds of plants produce white sap or latex, but Hevea brasiliensis tree is primary source of natural rubber used in commercial manufacturing of tires. Natural rubber is about 19% in car tires. It is about 34% in bigger tires meant for commercial vehicles. It has natural resistance to fatigue cracking. To attain other desired properties, it is mixed with compounds. Synthetic polymers. These are used in combination with natural rubber. These are butadiene rubber and styrene butadiene rubber. Physical and chemical properties of these polymers contribute to improve rolling resistance and traction control. These also reduce wear. Another polymer used is halogenated polyisobutylene rubber, also known as halobutyl rubber. This makes liner in tire impermeable. Car tires have about 24% of synthetic polymers. In tires meant for commercial vehicles, they are about 11%. Steel. Steel wire is used in belts. This gives extra strength to tire. Beads in tire have steel strands twisted together to form wire of suitable diameter. This gives shape to tire as already mentioned. It holds tire in rim of wheel. Tires that are required to take up heavy loads have steel wires in their plies also. This again adds to the strength of tire. textile. These are various cords used in tire. These can be polyester cord fabric, rayon cord fabric, nylon cord fabric, or aramid cord fabric. Aramid cord fabric is a class of heat resistant and strong synthetic fabrics. These are used as primary reinforcing material in casing of tire. These contribute in enhancing endurance. Enhanced endurance improves the performance of tire. These also provide stable shape to tire. Carbon black and amorphous precipitated silica. These are used as fillers to reinforce rubber. These improve resistance to abrasion and tensile strength of rubber. Carbon black is in the form of fine powder of amorphous carbon. It is obtained as soot by partial combustion of hydrocarbons. Amorphous precipitated silica is a form of synthetic amorphous silicon dioxide. It is derived from quartz sand, a crystalline form of silicon dioxide. Its physical properties are manipulated during manufacturing process for use in tire as filler. It is particularly helpful in enhancing rolling resistance. Few other fillers in use are products of calcium carbonate, barium sulfate, and mica. Mica acts as a dusting agent. It provides non-sticking surface to tire walls. Antioxidants. These prevent tires from breaking down due to their exposure to varying temperatures. These do not allow the process of oxidation due to oxygen present in atmosphere. Antioxidants that react at low temperature are constituent of tire material. Antioxidants that react at high temperature are added to natural and synthetic rubber polymers to make tire treads. Phosphite polymers have good antioxidant properties and make tire more stable. Anti-ozonants. Exposure to ozone causes cracks in synthetic rubber used in tires. It is known as ozone cracking. Anti-ozonants help to slow down cracking of tire. In natural rubber used in a tire, anti-ozonants protect against cracking and thermal deterioration. These agents used in combination with anti-ozonant waxes protect against ozone weathering. There are certain agents available that act as anti-ozonant and antioxidant both. These are capable of providing protection against thermal deterioration, fatigue, ozone and oxygen aging. Sulfur and zinc oxide. Vulcanization is a process used in tire making. It is a chemical process. In this process, rubber is heated with sulfur, thiazol, and zinc oxide up to a temperature between 140 and 160 degrees Celsius. Cross links are formed between long rubber molecules. This improves elasticity, resilience, tensile strength, viscosity, hardness, and weather resistance of rubber. Sulfur and zinc oxide act as curing agents and reduce time to complete vulcanization. Thiazol is a chemical compound that contains sulfur and nitrogen. It is in the form of pale yellow liquid with fish-like smell. It acts as vulcanization accelerator. As is known to us, tires are made of rubber compound, natural or synthetic. These are reinforced by plies that have fabric cord or steel wire. Rubber compounds stretch easily, whereas fabric cord or steel wire stretches to a limited extent. Bonding these dissimilar materials requires specialized process. Cords or steel wire are coated with rubber and adhesives. This is done before bonding them with other components during tire curing. Tire curing. It gives final shape and tread pattern to tire. Chemical cross-linking of rubber and vulcanizing agents produce elastomer. It is a natural or synthetic polymer with elastic properties. Steam at high pressure is used to create heat and required pressure for curing. Now it is a thing of past. It had several disadvantages such as cost, difficulty in handling, and quality impairment. Quality impairment is due to overheating if steam is at more than specified temperature. It is also due to condensation if steam is at a lower temperature than specified. Now, steam is replaced by nitrogen. It allows selection of pressure independently without affecting curing temperature. It also eliminates quality impairment. Strength of bonds should not deteriorate with use. To maintain bond strength, contamination of components should be prevented. This can be done by avoiding overload or underinflation. Also, impact with potholes and curbs or pinching of tire between rim and road surface causes contamination of components. This causes reduction in bond strength and life of tire. Above mentioned situations can be avoided by careful driving habits. This helps in achieving longer tire life. I conclude here. Thanks for watching.